everybody. Yeah, don't mind the weird getup. Anyway, hey everybody, how are you? I hope you're having an amazing day. So today I'm coming to you with a slightly different video. Now a little while ago I saw the Netflix movie called Bright. Yes, I really, really did enjoy it. I felt like kind of doing a challenge. So I have some prosthetics laying around here that I got from fellow artists. And I thought maybe I can challenge myself in trying to create a Bright orc makeup look with the prosthetics that I have. Now quickly, a disclaimer. I darn well know that the look does not look exactly like a Bright orc, but that is the whole purpose of this challenge. I wanted to see if I could use some random prosthetics and get as close to a Bright orc look as possible. Studio ADI did an amazing job. I mean, when I saw up close pictures of the orcs that they created, I was blown away by the paint job because in the movie, the lighting doesn't really do it justice in my opinion. So I already liked it in the movie, but when I saw, like, you know, the pictures of the orcs, I was like, wow. So I've never done a paint job like this before. I have no idea how they did it, but I'm just gonna give it my best shot and see if this is all gonna work. Now I want to make it perfectly clear that I have not purchased any specific products for this challenge because I wanted to see if I could do it with the products that I have laying around in my makeup room. So I have some random prosthetics here by RBFX and InfectedFX. I have some contact lenses laying around and I have some fake teeth laying around. I'm just gonna see if I can give off the vibes of a Bright orc, Namisa style. So let's start. So as you can see, here I am clean faced and ready to apply some Telesis 7 on the bridge of my nose. Why I'm applying it on the bridge of my nose first? Well, that's because it's the center of my face. And that way I'm sure that my prosthetic will be aligned correctly with the rest of my face. So in the center. Once I've applied a layer onto my face and also a layer onto the prosthetic, I'm just gonna press it down. Now you've seen me apply prosthetics a lot of times actually in my previous tutorials. So if you need some more information on that, just click on any of my previous tutorials to check that out. But what I wanna say is that take your time with, you know, gluing down your prosthetic, whether it's on yourself or on a model. Take your time because you don't want any bad edges if you can't hide them. What I mean by that is, unless you have a wig or clothing or accessories that will cover up the edges, please be careful because it's going to be very obvious. Trust me, I still experience this to this day. Once I've applied that brow piece fully, I'm taking a little bit of translucent powder and a powder puff and I'm applying that all over the edges. Just to make sure that the edges or something else like my finger won't stick to the leftover adhesive. It's a neat little trick Jeffrey Taylor taught me. I usually did this with a brush, but it's way easier with a powder puff. For me, it also helps with smoothing down the edges one more time. Okay, so I was also contemplating on adding these crazy ears, but in the end, I just didn't go for it. So instead, I was ready to apply the nose prosthetic. And it's pretty much the same thing as with the brow prosthetic. First, I'm aligning the center part of the prosthetic, and then I'm just going to glue the rest down. I had some trouble with this prosthetic because it is not made for my face, but yeah, I said I was gonna make it work, and gosh darn it, I will. So after applying the nose, I of course was ready to paint the prosthetics. So I used a Thomas Supernant prosthetic paint and I diluted it a bit with some water and I'm applying that all over the brow and nose. I'm also applying it a little bit onto my actual skin, but later on I'm going to use a Krylon TV paint stick in the shade G165 and apply that mostly on the edges of the prosthetic and the rest of my skin to match it more to, you know, what the color looks like on the prosthetic. So now I'm just taking a sponge to still use that prosthetic paint, and then with a brush, right now, I'm applying that Krylon TV paint stick. I mostly like to use this cream product around my eyes and mouth because those are very sensitive areas, so I rather stick to cream paints and stuff like that.
After that, I created a mixture with Thomas Supernaut's Royal Blue and Black Heart prosthetic paints with a tiny bit of green PAX paint by Mel Products. And I also diluted that mixture and just applied that in a random pattern on my forehead and a little bit on my cheeks. Now, it really helps to have some reference pictures of the bright orcs so you can create your own pattern, or you can try to create an existing orc pattern, if that makes sense. Now I'm using different tools to create these patterns. As you can see, I used a stippling brush by Delium Tools. I'm using a sponge, which I plucked some tiny pieces out of to create an irregular pattern, sort of say. And yeah, I'm just pretty much creating random shapes on my face while keeping, you know, my reference picture in the back of my mind. Now it's very difficult for me to explain what I'm actually doing, but the first layer of product is kind of light, right? And then the second layer is a little darker. Well, I'm trying to create depth in the makeup. If I were to paint on big blue blobs on my face, the makeup wouldn't come alive. It would feel really flat and 2D. And that's not what I want. So even though it's blue, I want it to look like skin. So what I did next is actually mix two alcohol activated makeup colors together, a black and a army green, and a lot of alcohol. And by that I mean 99% isopropanol alcohol. And I'm just applying that in a random pattern close to the edges where that blue and lighter skin tone meet. Yeah, I'm pretty much doing this to create more definition in the makeup look and to also stay true to my reference picture. So every now and then I will add a little bit more alcohol to the mixture or a little bit less, because I don't want the dots to all be the same color saturation, if that makes sense. So certain dots are a little darker and other dots are a little lighter. Now I love using this Delium Tools brush to create these kind of, well, I want to say dots, but they're irregular dots, like weird shaped. If you don't have a brush like this, something close to it would be, let's say, a large tapered blending brush in your regular makeup brushes. Next, I'm using a white alcohol activated makeup color and a spatter brush by Delium Tools. And as you can see, I'm flicking on some white speckles. I'm also gonna speckle on some black. Why? Because I saw it in my reference picture and it adds some freaking cool texture to the makeup. After that, I'm going back in with that white alcohol activated makeup color, and this time I'm using a blending brush actually, and I'm flicking on some big blobs of white. I'm also doing that with a black alcohol activated makeup color, simply because I wanted to change up the pattern in the makeup. And again, it really helps to look at your reference picture to know what types of textures you might want to add. With this, I made sure that I used a lot of alcohol, so isopropanol alcohol, so I could create some big spatters. As you can see, sometimes I'm using a sponge to kind of blend it away, and I'm also using the brush itself to create some more texture. But with this, I just made sure that I had a lot of alcohol on the brush, so it's only a light wash of color. Next up, I'm taking that black and kind of green mixture again, even though it looks like black now, and I'm just painting on some dots. Again, why am I doing this? Because my reference picture showed that the orc had some dots, mostly near the nose area and near the areas that were closest to the lighter skin color, so that's pretty much what I'm doing. Now, I'm using that black and green mixture, okay, I will give it to you, mostly black, first, but after that, I'm taking white, as you can see right here, and I'm pretty much doing the same thing. While you're looking at me creating dots, I quickly want to say that if you don't have these products at home, it is okay. You can definitely substitute some products, let's say for cream paints or maybe even eyeshadows, or you can create your own prosthetics. Just do whatever you are able to do, and just know that practice makes perfect. and I believe in you. Trust me, I know what it is to not be able to afford all the products that people use. Now I'm using a rosy skin color to actually create some texture on the lighter skin parts. I'm also applying more texture on the nose area. I'm also cleaning up my lips because I want my own lip color to shine through. It's just pretty much taking care of certain details in the makeup look that I forgot to do earlier. So now I'm pretty much going back in with that green and black mixture to create some more texture on the chin. I'm also making sure that my lips match with the rest of the makeup look as well. You know, just some details that I missed earlier, pretty much. Now next, I'm taking that Kryolan TV paint stick in the shade G165 again, only this time I'm applying it on my eyelid and underneath my lower lash line to blend it in with the rest of the prosthetics, of course. Because, well, obviously my eyes are a different color, like literally. Then next, I'm pretty much repeating the steps that I did in the beginning. I'm using that black slash green slash blue mixture as a base. And then after that, I'm applying that black and green alcohol activated makeup colors mix. And after that, I'm applying the dots to the eyes. You know, everything I did before, I'm now repeating near my eye area because, you know, that was pretty much left open. And yes, of course, I also applied that spattering technique to my eyes, as you can see right here. And honestly, I wish I painted the rest of my neck, but whatever. This is it for now. Now I'm going to pop in my contacts. And now I'm applying a product called Extremely Wet by Makeup Online. And I'm applying that to the nose area, the forehead, the highest points of the cheekbones. And this is what makes the skin come alive, pretty much. It's not going to look flat anymore. Now I will say this, off of camera, I did apply some more details to the makeup look because I took the mirror and looked up close and I felt like something was missing. So I added some more dots, some more spattering, etc., etc. And after that, I applied or reapplied that product called Extremely Wet again. And that is what you see me do right now. I had so much fun with this makeup look, you can't even imagine. Once I popped those fangs in by Scarecrow Vampire Fangs, I was like, okay, I see it happening. And look at those contacts by Chuck Silva though. Bam!
I had to take those teeth out for a minute, but here we go. Here's the final look. I quickly put on a beanie and a scarf so it would hide my neck. Ta-da! In all honesty, I didn't think this look was gonna work out because I do not know how they painted the orcs. So I just had to improvise, really. But I think it turned out pretty decent. I put in some contact lenses, as you can see. These lenses were custom made for me by Chuck Silva. I will leave his website here in the screen. Awesome lenses. I've been wearing his work for a couple of years now. And I'm so glad that he created these custom pairs for me. Now, if Studio ADI was actually gonna send me prosthetics and tell me how they did it, I would do this look again. But I don't think that miracle is gonna happen. But yeah, I had lots of fun creating this. Now, if you want to follow me on my social media pages, then all you have to do is type in Makeup by Namaisa on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Snapchat. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. Thank you all so much for your support. It means the world to me. And until the next video, bye!